The Spiders put a resounding finish on their season-opening unbeaten homestand against McNeese. The offense scored 80-plus for the fourth straight game, while the defense shined, allowing 57 points. McNeese, third in the nation in three-point accuracy at 45%, shot 4 for 20 behind the line, while the Spiders were hitting what would be a season-high 16 threes. Blake Francis poured in 20, Nick Sherrod 17. The Spiders were ready to leave the comforts of home for the first time. A Barclays Center date with Wisconsin was 3 days away, but this date was Friday, November 22nd, 2019. McNeese at Richmond.
Tip-off brought to you by ServPro of Richmond and Chesterfield. ServPro like it never even happened. Sit back, relax, and enjoy Spider basketball tonight from the Robins Center in Richmond, Virginia. With Greg Beckwith, I'm Bob Black, and our Spider TV crew. And the Spiders will get a chance to fire up the game's first shot. See if, oh, but they turn it over. A rare turnover by Gilliard, and back the other way, a driving layup by Roydell Brown.
Now they're going to try to double team right there. It's 1-3-1, the press, Bob, a little bit, the Cowboys, so you got to be ready for it if you're Richmond.
Golden attacks immediately as Greg Beckwith wanted him to, and he ties the game.
That's what he can do, Bob. Get the ball into Golden, let him get off, and make the shots come a little easier for the Spiders.
Grant, 11 points, 12 rebounds in the win over CSUN, his 11th career double-double. Shooting a little bit better than 50% from the field now. Spiders match up man-to-man. A.J. Lawson, redshirt junior, transfer from North Texas. Now Brown against KO. Brown muscles his way to the basket. It spills out, and KO yanks down the rebound. Nathan averaging about 4 boards per contest. Francis with a driving layup, but an offensive foul.
It was a really nice move by Blake. And when he went to the hole, there's a guy that rotated over, took a charge.
Chris Mooney's 15th season at Richmond, now 253 and 215. Here's the charge call. Leslie Jones, Chance Moore, Wally Rotecki, our officials.
That was a nice crossover move by Blake. But at times, you have to stop and pull up for that little teardrop. He has that in his arsenal.
Now the Spiders will show some forecourt pressure, full court pressure very early in the game. A.J. Lawson, 21 assists, but 27 turnovers in their first 6 games. Kennedy starts on the perimeter, hook it down on the low block. There's the first three for Cuxhausen. Nothing but the bottom of the net.
Well, you're going to have to get out on him pretty far out through the Spiders. He can shoot it really deep. We saw in the highlights in the beginning how far he can shoot it.
Now 27 of 54 from three-point range. Unconscious. And McNeese State with the early three-point lead. A little one-on-one move by Golden, but he left it short. And Shamarcus Kennedy, averaging 9 rebounds a game, grabs that one.
Well, Bailey Blake, Grant, one-on-one, Bob. It's going to be, he can make a lot of points tonight, but that's where you have to stop Kennedy. He's really good offensive rebounder, 9.3 rebounds total, but nice stick back by him that time.
He has had some big-time games against big-time opponents already this year. 20 points against Wisconsin, 26 against New Mexico. Backdoor cut, Blake Francis from Grant Golden.
Just waiting for that one to happen. A lot of pressure on the floor, Bob, in the perimeter at time. Again, great pass by Grant Golden.
Golden has shown he is an outstanding passer for a guy at 6'10". And a three-point McNeese lead. Francis went for the steal. Thought he might have tipped it off of Cuxhausen, but it'll remain McNeese ball. The Cowboys coached by Heath Schroyer. His second year at McNeese State, but he is a well-traveled coach, Greg, both as a head coach and an assistant. Portland State, Wyoming, UT Martin as a head coach and an assistant everywhere, really, from NC State to BYU.
Yeah, he's been all over. Started at high school, at DeMatha High School up here in Maryland, Bob, so familiar with the area a little bit, I guess. It's all those.
First change for Richmond is Andre Gustafson, and Gustafson loses the ball at midcourt. Cuxhausen again.
It's ridiculous how quick a release he has.
Well, Coach Scheuer earlier this year already said he is the best shooter in the country. And they've been all over the country, so he knows of what he speaks.
8,000 miles traveled already this year for the Cowboys.
Yeah, they know the difference in an aisle and a window seat on an airplane. Nick Sherrod answers right back, though. His 16th three-pointer of the year, 55% from beyond the arc.
He's looking really good, Bob. Pure shooter right now for the Spiders is Nick Sherrod.
And a five-point McNeese State lead. Roydell Brown, and now Cookshausen off of the dribble. Back to Brown with the jump hook. Offensive rebound, Kennedy back up.
Travel.
And a travel.
Yes.
Took a little hop step as he went to go back up from under the rim. Jamarcus Kennedy, the player of the week in the Southland Conference.
And Bob, you're gonna really have to box him out tonight, the Spiders, because he gets after, he's very active around the rim.
Spiders would love to get this one for Chris Mooney. Richmond has never started 4-0 under Coach Mooney. First time since the 2012-2013 season that the Spiders started 3-0. Jake Wojcik also in for Richmond. He comes in for Gustafson.
Little zone
now. Wide spread zone.
Spiders got enough good shooters out there. Should be able to do damage.
Kale has it rejected with authority, but another travel call coming on McNeese State. That one on Cookshausen. Spiders inbound. Sal Caressi off of the Richmond bench. KO. Sherrod again, catch and shoot three, side of the rim to the right side. And Roydell Brown, who averages six boards a game, grabs that one. Leandre Washington, sub in for McNeese State. Here's KO with the steal. KO to the basket, lost the ball. Gilliard, though, spins it in off the backboard. What hustle by Jacob Gilliard.
What hustle, what nice play. Spun that off the backboard, the first layup.
What a twisting, acrobatic shot, but give him credit for not assuming that KO was going to finish that play. Spiders capitalize off of the turnover. We've already had three by each team here in the first 5 minutes. Now it's Wojcik's turn to guard Cookshausen. Kennedy, and he traveled.
Oh, I don't know about that one. quick steal by KO on that play. Nice play. Went in, looked like he's going to have a layup. Good hustle by McNeese, but Gilliard stayed with it, Bob, and put a nice shot, a twisting shot up.
Fourth turnover by the Cowboys, who show a different kind of pressure now. A little zone in the backcourt. Tyler Burton off of the Spider bench. So Coach Mooney's already gone nine deep. Gilliard shooting over the zone, ties the game.
Yeah, that's the beauty of this, having some shooters in. Break that zone.
Jacob Gilliard averaging 23 points a game. That is 16th in the nation. And that's his 11th three-pointer. And did he get a steal? Yes, he did. He knocked the ball out of the hands of Washington, who lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, quick hands. Jacob, the quickest hands I've seen as a defender, Bob.
Yeah, this is really interesting, Greg, and you can talk to this as a former quick point guard. We had him on our morning radio show this week, and Andrew Wallace, my partner, asked him a great question. What's the most important attribute you need to have as a small point guard? As Francis misses that three, Tyler Burton with the rebound and the follow.
Really nice. Really nice.
Anyway, Gilliard's answer, Greg, was quickness, but it wasn't physical quickness. He said mental quickness.
You have to be ahead of the game, and that comes instinctive, Bob. You instinctively anticipate because of the mental preparation.
Gilliard went for the steal, didn't get it, picks up the personal foul, but Jacob Gilliard is leading this Spider comeback. Richmond, we mentioned in the CSUN game, railed off 16 straight and 22 straight. This is a 10-0 run here.
Yeah, nice run, and that's a nice offensive rebound by Burton. Let's stick that in.
Gilliard picking up the foul, his first. Cookshausen guarded by Blake Francis. He'll get in his jersey. Boy, that was a fastball on the near side to Lawson, who misses it, and a tough rebound on the weak side by Grant Golden.
Yeah, good box out by Grant that time.
And Gilliard zigged when Golden thought he was going to zag, and the ball went out of bounds.
It's a good idea that time. I actually thought it hit off of Washington for McNeese that time. It looked like it grazed him.
So the Spiders turn it over for the fourth time. We've already had 9 turnovers in the game in the first 7 minutes. And a 2-point Richmond lead by virtue of a 10-0 run here in the last 4 minutes. Tough shot from the baseline, missed, and Tyler Burton skies for the rebound.
Some athleticism there with Burton, I'll tell you that.
Makes a quick pass inside to Golden. Golden has it blocked. Golden gets it back. Golden has it blocked again. Gustafson gets it back, and he's fouled.
Little plays like that by Gustafson. Loose balls, stick backs by Burton go a long way.
McNeese State trying to be as physical with Grant Golden as they possibly can, aren't they?
Yeah, and I like it, though. You got to keep going after the shot blocker if you're Grant Golden. Got to use his body a little bit more. He's showing a lot of ball too early.
They will block some shots. They had 22 blocks coming into this game in their first 6 contests, and for everything else that Shamarcus Kennedy does, he leads him in block shots with 11. And the Spiders turn it over again. Francis gets it right back. Drives to the basket and got hip-checked by Sam Baker, the 6'4 junior.
Yeah, smart play by Blake that time. Put his body in front of the player, the McNeese State player, but just anticipation. We talked about anticipation, understanding when the next pass is coming. Good play by Blake to draw that foul.
Blake Francis on the line to shoot 2.
And McNeese State turns the ball over at least 17 times a game right now, so the Spiders can get some steals and easy buckets in transition.
Nick Sherrod had gone out for a breather. He's back. Jacob Gilliard's going to get his first rest. He and Golden both on the bench, so let's see how the Spiders play without their two leaders. Francis, 4 points, 2 of 2 at the free throw line. And a 4-point Spider lead. And now a 12-0 run. Cuxhausen is out for McNeese at the moment. Burton stepped into the passing lane, almost got that one. A.J. Lawson called for traveling. I know Coach Mooney doesn't like the offensive turnovers, but he's got to like what the Spiders are getting at the other end of the floor right now.
Well, they're making turnovers, Bob. The Spiders are not hanging their heads. They're getting back on defense and getting back into passing lanes, which is good.
Francis over the zone, around the rim and out. And Kennedy with another rebound, already his 4th. Their lead is 4. Chris Orlina in the game. This is about as close to a homecoming as he's going to get. He's from Norfolk.
Yeah.
Entry pass to Shamarcus Kennedy for his 2nd bucket. You can see where he can be a handful in the paint.
He's long, Bobby. Long arm. Very athletic player. Energetic player. Kennedy.
6'8", 220-pound senior. Sherrod skips it to Francis. Sweet looking 3.
Good skip pass by Sherrod that time.
Just so many weapons on the perimeter for Richmond. Spiders 3 for 6 from beyond the arc. The lead is 5. The run is 15-2. Lawson, the North Texas transfer, in the corner, deep 3, Washington. Kennedy with the rebound, up over Burton for 2 more.
Yeah, he's got some leaping ability. Snagged that one out of the air, didn't he?
Your old coach, the Hall of Famer Dick Tarrant, used to say about rebounding, he who wants it, gets it. Shamarcus Kennedy wants it, doesn't he?
He hit on that one especially, didn't he?
Again, Richmond attacking the zone. Sherrod from Caressi. That will be McNeese ball. And that will be a timeout. Good start today. Halfway through the first half from the Robins Center in Richmond, Virginia. The Spiders, by virtue of a 15-2 run, have opened up a 19-16 lead. 10:06 to go, first half. We'll be back to the RVA.
Wow, we talked about those threes at the beginning of the telecast, and you can see the Spiders are right there at 43%. That's their season average for three-point range. As you mentioned, it's a variety of players can make those shots from three-point range for the Spiders. You're seeing it in this first half.
McNeese with the ball following the timeout, and it will be the Norfolk native, Chris Orlina, 6'6 junior, to inbound for the Cowboys. There's your field goal numbers from three-point range and some of the other stats. The turnovers, the highest numbers on the board right now. That's a deep three by Sam Baker, who's probably their second best three-point shooter at 48%. He missed that one.
Yeah.
Starting five back on the floor now for Richmond.
Kingshausen's been on the bench for a while for McNeese State, their sharp shooter.
Man-to-man. Gilliard, that's a tough shot, and he drew the foul with a hit on the arm.
Yeah, one-on-one move by Jake that time. Felt he could take his guy off to dribble Washington. He did. Drew the foul.
Jacob Gilliard on the line to shoot two.
Really see this by Jake. Stop, pop, get fouled.
Gilliard had 18 points in the win over CSUN Sunday. 4 of 6 from three-point range. Another great assist turnover game. 7 assists, 1 turnover, 5 steals.
And what you like about Jake Gilliard, Bob, he hasn't forced it at all. He picks his moments in the game, situations, and just starts attacking and dominating.
1 of 2 at the foul line. So a 4-point Richmond lead. Lawson brings it across midcourt. Now Kennedy guarded by Golden. There's the matchup you previewed on our pregame. Johnson inside, missed that one, and good hustle by Kao to come up with the loose ball. Spiders have numbers here. Gilliard, 9 points.
Good setup that time by Jake Tishrod, back to Zeke for the three.
It's almost automatic right now the way these guys are shooting. And the Spiders enjoy their biggest lead. Trey Johnson, a 6'2 sophomore from Baton Rouge. With the ball right now. He thought he'd be a redshirt freshman this year. Cuxhausen, another one, his third three. He's back in the game. Made his presence known.
Yes, he did. Such a quick release, the defender doesn't realize he's got to shoot it that quick.
And that deep.
And that deep.
How will the Spiders answer? Sherrod, teardrop, halfway down and out. And Roydell Brown with that rebound. In the corner, that is a deep three by Johnson, who missed it. Nice job by Wojcik. He was in the jersey of Cuxhausen, out behind the three-point line, and came charging in to get that defensive rebound. Golden along the baseline, missed on the power move. But Kennedy can't hang on to it. He tried to tip it to himself, and it went too far and over the baseline. So the Spiders will have it back when we come back with 7:42 to go in the first half. Drew Cuxhausen now with 3 threes. He's 3 for 3 from the floor. Spiders with a 4-point lead.
Well, both of those games, though, they said were very competitive. And McNeese State gets back down. Scores a little bit misleading.
They are a travel-tested team. Gilliard off the inbound for Richmond, which has yet to pack a bag until this weekend.
Be a good challenge for those guys in New York, Bob, the Spiders.
And a chance to play on the floor where the Atlantic 10 tournament will be held in March. That's a blocking foul as Golden took it strong to the basket. Greg, I was just thinking during the break, Gilliard and Francis have 16 of the Spiders' 23 points in the backcourt. How are the front court guys going to get involved like Grant just did?
Well, that's exactly right. He's got to be more aggressive, but I like what he did right before the break and the timeout, Bob. He drew the foul, but he used his body as well when he's in a block against Kennedy. Kennedy's such a long-arm athletic guy. Grant has to use his body a little bit better, and he showed it last couple times on that block.
Much better at the free throw line this season. Grant now 7 for 9.
One thing I've noticed about Grant in the post, Bob, this year versus last year, and you know he went down to Houston and got some tutelage from some professionals down there, John Lucas and those guys, he's really more patient on the block and understanding where he is. Before, he used to get behind the backboard. We saw that last year a couple of times, get out of position. Now he's taking his time. He's getting his shots where he wants on the floor.
He was a 66% free throw shooter last year. He is off to an 80% start this year, 8 for 10. Spider lead at half a dozen. Sam Baker has deep range, shooting 48% from three, 6'4 junior. Kennedy, quick pass to Brown over Burton.
He's a 6'6 senior, Bob. He's real strong body. He attacks the rim very hard.
Roydell Brown missed the last eight games at the end of last season with an ankle injury. That seems to have come back fully recovered now. Preseason second team Southland Conference selection along with Shamarcus Kennedy. Quick move by Francis. Nice feathery finish too.
Just such a quick step by Francis that time. Ian Gilliard had a really quick first step to get around their man.
Those guards are winning this game right now. 18 of the Spiders 27. 9 each for Gilliard and Francis. Blake almost with a steal. Cuxhausen shoots over him and missed that one. Blake forced him into that miss.
Yeah, good challenge that time by Blake.
Golden thought about the backdoor cut, gave it up to Francis on the perimeter instead. Wow, how did Francis find Gilliard there? He missed it, but there's an offensive rebound for Golden and maybe a little bit too unselfish. Looked like he had a shot. He tried to find the freshman Burton. And a foul was called.
Yeah, he got fortunate that time. He got a foul by McNeese State that time, wasn't it? Yeah.
Grant trying to plead his case that it would be a shooting foul. DeAndre Washington picks up his second foul. Both coaches making changes here. Andre Gustafson for Richmond. Nick Sherrod goes out. Truman Moore, a 6'8 sophomore, is in for the first time for McNeese State. Francis and Gilliard. And now Golden and Gustafson. Around and out. And Orlina the rebound.
Yeah, I'd like to see Goose hit one of those shots. He needs that for his confidence.
I would echo the same thoughts for Jake Wojcik when he gets in there. It's a nice look and a finish for Truman Moore. Averages 4.5 points a game, coming off a career-high 12 in their win over Arlington Baptist in their last game. A National Christian College Athletic Association Division II school.
Oof.
103-51. Nice move by Golden.
There you go. Patience on the block. Back this man in. Gathered himself and made a nice little turnaround shot.
Yeah, if they don't give Moore some help on that, Grant's going to have a field day down low. Washington weaving through traffic and the foul as Golden went for the block. He'll pick up his first. DeAndre Washington to the free throw line. This is his third stop, his freshman year at Robert Morris up in your neck of the woods, right?
Yep.
Pittsburgh area.
Oh, yeah.
And Barton Community College, Englewood, New Jersey native.
Said 12 newcomers to the McNeese State team. A lot of them transfers.
Oh, yeah. 11 of their 14 on the roster came from somewhere else and in many cases more than one other place. They are talented, but that makes it very challenging, doesn't it, for the chemistry issue. They do have a lot of individual athleticism and talent, but you got to mesh it all together.
Yeah. Well, the University of New Orleans is favored in their conference, Bob. McNeese State's preseason 7th pick.
Francis. Gustafson down the lane, lost it. Spiders turn it over for the 6th time. Matt Grace in for Richmond in the middle there. The 10th Spider to play here in the first half. Good D by Jacob Gilliard. Right now he's got Cuxhausen. Washington to the basket, spins it home and one.
Wow, nice drive. One thing, if you watch the Spiders defense, Bob, I'm so concerned about Cuxhausen that it spread the Spiders out and left the lane wide open. That's one of the things that we talked about this three-point line. It really supposed to spread the lane out and gives you open lanes to drive, and that time Washington took advantage of it. But that's what a three-point shooter can do. It can really open it up.
Not complete the three-point play, and Matt Grace with the rebound, protecting a two-point Richmond lead. And they're going to press even off a miss here, not off a made field goal or free throw. And drop back into a zone. Sherrod, catch and shoot, three. That is a smooth-looking stroke, yes, sir.
Twined on the net. Love to hear it.
Spiders 5-for-11 from beyond the arc. Grace guarding Moore, who backs his way in. Tries to go up and under. Travel. And a foul called on Matt Grace.
Detail-oriented person. I had to be really detailed. The scouts are not fun sometimes.
Steve Thomas. Oh, what a block by Nathan Kale. Swatted that one away. And the long three by Baker misses. And they get a held ball, which belongs to McNeese State. Steve Thomas was the Spiders director of basketball operations, one of the best we've ever had at that position. And I'm sure he will be equally as talented in his assistant coaching role.
Yeah, when guys like Kayo come over and do that, makes you look good as a coach,
as
I can
tell.
Yes, it does.
19 on the shot clock. Cuxhausen comes off a screen, puts it on the floor and drives it to the basket, and Kale the rebound, and Cuxhausen is a little shaken up. He's slow in getting back, and the Spiders in transition get three more from Nick Sherrod.
Exactly what you want to do with Cuxhausen. Put him on the move, Bob. Make him take some tough shots. And Francis is making you do that.
And a wise timeout by McNeese State head coach Heath Scheuer. The Spiders opening up an 8-point lead.
Fast break that time to find Nick Sherrod on the left wing to bury it. Good spot up there. Always want to find a guy who's hot.
Spiders got a lot of them. Richmond now from 3-point range, 6-for-12 tonight. And 12 of 24 from the floor. Nick Sherrod, 3-for-6, all of them 3-pointers. For his 9 points.
Yeah, he looks very good, Bob. Very comfortable out there shooting.
McNeese State last year, 9-22, 5-13 in the Southland Conference, and as Greg mentioned, preseason 7th in the conference this year. 8-point lead is Richmond's biggest. Gilliard guarding Washington. Now Kennedy, who's been relatively quiet, 6 points here in the first half. Another turnover.
Nice play by Jake Gilliard. Coming over to help out that time, Bob.
Spiders could enjoy their first double-figure lead of the game. Sherrod, Francis. KO goes for the rebound, but will be called for pushing off.
Good call. Leslie is right in front of that one. Referee.
First foul on Nathan KO, who has not yet scored tonight. As we approach 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Kennedy, their leading scorer, hasn't missed a shot yet, but he's only taken three. Spiders have done a pretty good job of keeping the ball out of his hands. In fact, I just glanced at him, and he's kind of shaking his head like, why am I not getting the ball right now?
Yeah, he looks frustrated right now.
Brown has it knocked away and out of bounds by Nathan Kao. Good low post defense there by Nate.
1 second on the shot clock, too, so the Spiders have to be aware of it.
Watch out for Kennedy leaping to the rim here. Nope. That's going to be a shot clock violation. They never had control of the ball. And McNeese State turns it over for the ninth time.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. The Spiders are really frustrating McNeese State on the defensive side of the ball. The Spiders are doing a nice job.
And again, Richmond will have a chance to go up by double figures here with the starting five on the court for the home team. Golden backs in on Kennedy. Big on big with the jump hook and a 10-point Richmond lead. Grant has eight.
I love it. I love the patience by Grant. Again, knowing where he is on the floor, backed his man in and made it look easy.
See if the Spiders can finish off this first half now. Standstill three by Lawson. Rims out, but Orlina sneaks in there for the offensive rebound. Washington has it blocked by KO. Here come the Spiders. Francis. Gilliard. Three.
It's a great play by the Spiders, Bob. Defensively, pushing it up on offense and finding the open guy. Share the basketball.
It's an 11-0 run. There was a 12-0 run earlier. Golden blocks it. Baker inside Orlina. Outside Baker with two on the shot clock. The little guy, Gilliard, with the rebound. We talked about this the other night, Greg. I do think the Spiders can block more shots. They've got guys who can be intimidating around the rim.
Absolutely. Timeout by the Spiders to set up this last play with 11.3. But you're absolutely right, Bob. You have to be in a position to do that. We talked about the rotations. Richmond is doing a lot of rotations tonight. I think that the week off, we talked about defense a lot. I talked to Steve Jones about that. And he talked about a lot of, Coach Jones about that, saying a lot of defense was emphasized. And I talked to Coach Thomas. He said the same thing. He said, we spent a lot on the defensive side of the ball.
But that's a intimidation factor, and as it did tonight, it got the crowd in the game, right? You've got guys that can block some shots. KO's got two. Golden's got one. Sherrod has one tonight. Caressi can block shots. I think Tyler Burton is going to be a shot blocker.
There's not too many people around the country and fans that want to cheer on defense, right? Only one place we know.
Charlottesville.
UVA fans know when they see good defense.
Now last shot time for Richmond, up by 13. And we'll get the ball to start the second half.
1-3-1.
Gilliard bounces it to KO. Reverse scoop shot to finish off the first half on a 14-0 run for the home team.
Dominating performance the last half part of this half, Bob. Really like what the Spiders are doing on defense, though. Swarming defense leads to easy, fast break buckets.
Great game to watch it now. And the Spiders 20 minutes away from finishing off a perfect season opening homestand at 4-0. But you got to finish them here. And the Spiders will get a chance to start the second half with the ball. And turn it over on that opening possession, just what we were talking about.
All right, it's a good idea, but the coach looked at his assistants over there and said, catch that ball. KO has to catch that one.
McNeese with the ball for the first time in the second half. See if Kennedy starts to get the ball more in shooting position. See if they look for him. Golden right now blanketing him on the low post.
Started Washington at the point guard, Bob. Second half.
Lawson rolls it out, and Golden the rebound. France fourth. Gilliard with 12, Francis with 9, Sherrod with 9. Man-to-man by the Cowboys. Francis drew the foul on the three-point shot.
Yeah, they got Cuxhausen on the foul right there, flying out on Francis. Again, the Spiders have really nice spacing on the offense. That time Nick skipped it over to Francis. It's a long way to recover for Drew Cuxhausen.
I love how they find the open guy, and it doesn't really matter where on the court that open guy is. Could be cross court, could be quarter court.
And you know, Bob, I want to mention Johnson for McNeese State. Saw him limp out in that first half, 6'2 sophomore who started the game, and he's not starting in the second half. I wonder if his injury is causing him not to play that much.
And as we said, he played last year when he was supposed to redshirt because of other injuries. He should have been a redshirt freshman this year instead of the sophomore. And now I think you're right. I think he did limp off the court, and we haven't seen him back. All three free throws by Blake Francis. Cuxhausen off the mark, but the offensive rebound for Brown, and he puts it in.
That's a sheer hustle that time. He out-hustled Kale for that ball because Kale had really good blockout position there.
Break the press. Francis lost it out of bounds.
Good pressure here.
Brown needs some help and gets it from A.J. Lawson. Cuxhausen in the corner to Lawson. And now Brown backing in on KO and drew the foul.
He's a strong player. He's a physical player. Brown, 6'6".
There's the foul on KO. That'll be his second. Roy Del Brown to the free throw line to shoot two. 10 of 19 at the line. 10 of 20 now. So not a great free throw shooter. Missed them both. So 2 minutes into the second half, a 16-point Richmond lead. The run ended at 16 straight for the Spiders from the end of the first half to the start of the second half. Francis, he's got 15.
Yeah, they left him open that time.
Spiders will make you pay. And you go off your scouting report.
Thing is for Richmond, Bob, it's not, you don't see the grind. He's really struggling to score now for the Spiders. They got people who can score, and there's Kennedy on his bucket. But you really have a lot of guys as weapons to score. No grinded out.
The ball movement is just so good right now. It always leaves somebody open somewhere. Golden powers his way and dances it off the rim.
He's adjusted to the shot blocker. He uses his body very well that time.
10 for Grant. The lead is 19. Turnover. Dunk. KO.
Having fun, Bob. Nice steal and dunk.
The lead grows to 21. Lawson, they got away with a walk.
Euro, they call
Euro
that.
Euro step, yep.
Euro travel.
Four minutes into the second half from the Robbins Center, Richmond, Virginia. Gilliard to KO. Golden attacks. Sherrod shoots.
Ball movement, passing, flow, confidence. It's all there tonight for the Richmond Spiders.
9 of 16 from three-point range for Richmond. Cookshausen tied up. Washington tries a three. Golden there for the rebound.
Uh-oh. I said, I got this. Oh, he doesn't. Yeah.
I think he will probably hear about that one. Spiders with four in double figures. Francis, 15. Gilliard, Sherrod, 12. Golden, 10. KO has only four, but it includes that monster dunk.
Another steal and run out for the Spiders, Bob. And easy buckets in transition. They're really nice to see.
And some pressure now by the guards, Gilliard and Francis. Washington getting a lot of minutes. As you said, Greg, it looks like Trey Johnson out with an apparent injury, will not return. Sal Caressi has returned for Richmond. So has Tyler Burton. Cookshausen misses. Gilliard finds Francis. Hangs in the air and can't get it to go. Good look by Jake.
You'd have made that.
Gilliard knocks it away. Held ball belongs to McNeese State.
Yeah, I bet you McNeese State feels like there's six Spider players on the floor a lot of times.
Yeah.
They're all over the place with their hands.
Chris Mooney going a little bit more to his bench now. Greg, would love to see some of these guys come off the bench and get some points. Francis leaves as the leading scorer with 15. But now you've got Wojcik, Burton, Caressi in the game.
Yeah, I'd like to see Jake get some shots up and hit some, Bob. He needs that.
He only had three games last year where he did not score. He's already got three this year. About two this year, I beg your pardon. And he's got a foul there. He's
trying to find his role. This new team, this new Spider look this year. He's trying to find his role. Did such a nice job last year.
Sure did. He's coming off the bench now, whereas he started every game as a freshman.
Yeah.
Lawson with the jump hook over Burton. Lawson with six. And the lead is 20. The two starters on the court are Gilliard and Sherrod. Burton back to Sherrod. Looking for Gilliard, has it stolen. Washington on the run out, fouled by Burton.
The Spiders had him spread out, but just a errant pass by Nick that time. Didn't see Brown jump in the passing lane.
Tyler Burton, a 6'7 freshman, New Englander out of Massachusetts. Five points for Leandre Washington. And now Andre Gustafson off the Spider bench. Fifty-five, 37. Gilliard from midcourt. Caressi almost had it stolen. Sherrod.
The cleanup.
Yep. Nick now with 15. He's 5 for 7 from bonus land. Coming off of the career high 7 last Sunday. Washington and one. Gilliard on the over the back foul. Well, Leandre Washington taking advantage of some playing time tonight. We'll look to complete a 3-point play as Jacob Gilliard gets a second half rest.
Talking about efficient playing, Bob, and you look at the numbers that Nick Sherrod is putting up. Shooting has been tremendous. He's so efficient, like you said, from three-point range.
Yeah, he's close to 60% now from three-point range. Blake Francis back. He came in for Gilliard. Keeps his dribble. Takes the shot. Short. And Kennedy the rebound. Leading rebounder in the game with 7. Well, they'd like to get him the ball on offense. Brown tried to throw an alley-oop to him, and it was too high. Francis almost lost it, but the reach-in foul on Lawson. They're trying whatever they can, Greg, to get Kennedy the ball, aren't they? The Spiders just aren't letting him get open.
Well, after that first timeout in the second half, you could tell that the coaching staff said, hey, let's find Kennedy on the block. They've tried. The Spiders have done a nice job with the defense. Cressy's done a nice job pushing him off the block, Bob, and fighting for position in there.
Really good job. Francis off a tough catch. Still Richmond ball. Kennedy knocked it out.
Good hustle by Caressi. He's not scoring a lot of points, but he's doing little things. Defense, loose balls. Talked about just contributing in a positive way when you come off that bench. And Sal's done that so far this year, Bob.
Shot clock reset at 20. Caressi along the baseline. Burton steps into a three and bags it.
It's good for him as well.
That is his first collegiate three-pointer for Tyler Burton. And he's got 5 points in 10 minutes tonight. Like to see that off of the bench. Washington underneath to Kennedy, and the Spiders swarm him.
Spiders shooting 67% in the second half, Bob, from the field. Just on fire on the offensive end.
See the numbers on your screen overall, 57% for the game. And it's going to go up here on the Francis breakaway. 17 for the Herndon, Virginia native by way of Wagner. Gustafson guarding Lawson. Over Golden for 2 for A.J. Lawson. He was a scorer during his time at North Texas. He had a 31-point game as a freshman against Rice. Gustafson tries the entry pass to Golden, and it's knocked out of bounds.
Goose was too far out that time for that entry pass, Bob. You got to get in. A little foul line extended. That was a long pass to make for post-entry. Short the passing lane.
Burton's pass is stolen. Back come the Cowboys. Sam Baker has not scored tonight. Three ball from the corner.
Poyser.
Yeah, that's Poyser, and we know him. Jalen Poyser played a year at St. Bonaventure. Canadian found his way from UNLV to St. Bonaventure to McNeese State. Las Vegas to Olean to Lake Charles, wow. Louisiana. Huh?
A lot of road travel.
Golden missed it. Golden got it back. Golden finds KO. And Burton called for travel.
Yeah, little hot.
Yep.
Could have called 3 seconds twice in there. You don't see that call that much anymore.
Rarely. Yep. No, they'd rather call that flop call. Fortunately, we haven't seen that tonight.
I don't think the refs want to call that one.
No, I don't either. By their own admission, they are working through the interpretation of that one.
Yeah, it's tough.
Yep.
Pace has slowed up.
Really
Spiders,
slowed up, yes.
Spiders have controlled every aspect of this game.
Nick Sherrod controls the rebound.
Coach Mooney wanted to put his five back in to control the game. Refocused here.
Yep. You want to stay sharp, right?
Big week coming
up. Some big challenges coming up. Gilliard from deep, way beyond the line for Jacob. Just expect him to go in now, right? You sure do.
Absolutely.
The Spiders have Wisconsin Monday, then either Auburn or New Mexico Tuesday, and then after Thanksgiving, Boston College comes here to the Robins Center. Poyser missed it. Good box out by the little guy, Jacob Gilliard. Out of bounds off of Boston.
Coach Schroyer did not like that shot by Poyser. He was agitated, still is. Mm-hmm. Staring him down. As you mentioned, Bob, McNeese State, they have a lot of athletic players out there. It's just trying to get the chemistry right. Combinations with all these newcomers coming in, transfers. Just tough early on. They traveled a lot of miles as well, so it's just tough.
Gilliard tried to thread the needle that time and had it stolen, but Sherrod steals it right back, and the Spiders have numbers like the number three for another three ball from Blake Francis, and he's got a 20-point game tonight.
Stroking it.
The lead grows to 24. Off the side of the rim and out of bounds will still be McNeese ball.
You hit those threes like the Spiders are, you can just see the energy just being sapped away and just taken away from McNeese State.
13 three-pointers tonight. Grant Golden to the Richmond bench.
They see the assistant coach talking to Kennedy, Bob. He's just trying to keep his spirits up. He's just so frustrated out there. He's sitting on a bench now, just been frustrated the whole night by Richmond.
Yeah, they have done a tremendous job on him. Lawson too strong. Good rebound. Good box out by Nathan Cahill. Approaching 8 minutes to go in what's turned out to be a blowout for the Spiders. Francis, again, a little bit off that time. Lawson going coast to coast. And McNeese State will use a timeout as A.J. Lawson gets into double figures. He is the first Cowboy to reach double digits. He has 10 points on 5 of 14 shooting. 22-point Richmond lead with 7:58 to go. In the second half, Blake Francis leading the scoring barrage tonight with 20. We're back. Strong suit for Richmond. They're trying to get better at rebounding, so that might be something you look at tonight. Yeah. McNeese had out-rebounded its opponents by about 4 to this point, and they've played some quality competition. Wisconsin, New Mexico, Louisiana Lafayette. Francis off balance, hanging in the air, missed that one, but Caressi finishes it up for 2 with a chance at 3 for number 2.
That's what we're talking about with Sal Caressi, Bob. Loose ball that time, picked it up and finished it, got fouled.
TV timeout on the heels of Caressi's bucket. With 7:42 to go, Sal will be going to the free throw line when we come back.
Confident.
He looks more comfortable on the interior than he did last year. He's still slight of build, make no mistake about it, but he's picked up his weight and his strength. He's worked hard with Jay DeMayo, our strength and conditioning coach, and he looks more comfortable playing on the low block.
Yep.
Completes that three-point play. Crowd didn't like that call from Leslie Jones.
It's been a clean game for the most part.
Yep. Only the 16th foul on the Spiders with 7.5 minutes to play. Turnaround by Lawson. He's got a dozen points. He's their leading scorer tonight. I wonder if we'll even see Shamarcus Kennedy again in this game, limited to just 8 points. 8.7 rebounds.
He's been frustrated for sure.
Sherrod missed one. How dare he?
Wow. And that looked good from
yes,
where I was sitting.
Lawson again over Caressi, who played good defense and then fought for the rebound. Just what we're talking about with Sal Caressi. Nice finish by Gustafson.
Still Gilliard in the backcourt. Shot clock.
Yep. Yep. I'll have to reset that. Jacob Gilliard, too quick for the clock.
Yes, he was. This is kind of funny. Now, staying with it, Goose comes out of nowhere and finishes it. And then Jake's good.
I thought we'd see him do it. Yeah, I could see him sneaking on the side of the screen there.
Now, Kennedy's back in.
Yep.
6:32 left.
Gilliard and Sherrod, two starters on the court with Caressi, Gustafson, and Burton getting quality minutes here. Sherrod gets triple teamed. Gilliard, Caressi, three. He's feeling it. He's feeling it.
And you put up your signal three with your fingers, buddy. He's feeling it.
6 points, three rebounds, and an assist in 11 minutes. Orlina up and under. Burton battles for the rebound, tips it to Sherrod. A complete performance tonight by the Richmond Spiders. And now getting some production off their bench. Burton from Sherrod. More bench points.
And the basketball. Making it look easy, Bob.
Spiders now with 13 points off their bench. Been all the starters in the first three games. Tonight, getting some scoring from Caressi and Burton. That's an air ball right into the hands of Gustafson. Thread the needle, bounce pass to Sherrod, off the dribble. Stop and pop by Nick Sherrod. His pop would have liked that one.
I'm
and his grandpa.
They all like it. He is popping.
And the Robin Center crowd likes it. And why not?
Energy. For the Spiders, Bob, and how they're playing. You look at how they're sharing the basketball with Burton with a layup, the ball movement, the spread of the basketball, and the big threes. It's contagious. As Caressi hits his three, and then the stop and pop by Nick Sherrod there. And this is playing with a lot of confidence. Everybody's feeling good about their role. The energy levels there. You got to feel good about it. As you mentioned, a couple things that you're working on, I'm sure, is defensively. Spiders have done a nice job defensively tonight, especially against the two guys that they were concerned about. Kennedy coming in averaging 18 points, has been held. And then Kukoskowski, he hasn't done anything. Kukoskowski's been really quiet. Start off quick, but they really have taken a three-point shot away from him this evening as well.
Sal Caressi getting some quality minutes. Pick and roll to Kennedy, but he gives it up. Poyser way off the mark on the three, and back come the Spiders again.
Back-to-back air balls for McNeese State from the perimeter.
Only thing left in doubt now is will the Spiders get to 90 for the fourth straight game? That one won't count. That won't add to the total. That'll be an offensive foul on Tyler Burton.
That was on Tyler Burton. That's his second.
Turnover's a little high for Richmond, but we're kind of nitpicking.
A little bit.
Yeah. Spiders' 14th turnover. Well, what is assured is the Spiders will be 4-0 for the first time under head coach Chris Mooney in his 15th season. First time since your 85-86 team. It started 8-0. Then you lost to who?
Team called Georgia Tech. It was ranked number one at the time. It wasn't fun.
Then you won 8 more in a row.
Yes, we did.
Got to 16-1. Coach Mooney would take a repeat of that.
Yeah, but I think the key for those teams, Bob, you talk about experience and playing time. And I think that's the key of these teams. Once you get that experience, you understand your role, responsibilities.
Well, you, Newman, and Davis were all seniors on that team in 85-86. This team doesn't have any seniors, but it's got juniors who play like seniors.
A lot of playing time for those guys.
Gustafson comes up with a loose ball. And as an aside, I still contend if John Davis hadn't gotten hurt that year, that could have been the best Spider team of them all. Saying a lot.
Yeah, this team, as Coach Mooney has said, has a chance to really be a really good team.
Caressi and Burton lost that one, but will maintain possession after the under 4 minute timeout. Our final break of a Spider blowout. Richmond up 81-49 on McNeese State. The Spiders with four in double figures. And either Auburn or New Mexico and Boston College.
I think their confidence, Bob, that's the thing. They're playing with a lot of confidence. I think that's the thing that you like about the Spiders. And a foul by Grace there. An errant pass out of bounds under coming out of that timeout. No, Coach not going to like that. Good foul by Grace for Renee for the layup. But just think that they feel like they're playing with a lot of confidence. And again, you still have to tidy up on the defensive end. Some things. And when you play teams like Wisconsin or New Mexico or Auburn that they may face for sure, Wisconsin, that's when you have to rebound and do the little things and box out. That's when it's going to be really physical. They'll have to make some shots when they get bumped and stuff like that. So, but right now, they're playing with a lot more confidence, and they look comfortable in their roles individually.
Happened to watch the second half of the Wisconsin game last night against Green Bay. They look really solid. They got a lot of parts. The Badgers do. Had that season-opening loss to St. Mary's, and they haven't lost since. It's a foul in the backcourt on Washington. So that'll be fun up there at Barclays Center Monday and Tuesday. The Monday game is at 7 o'clock against Wisconsin, and then Tuesday either 5 or 7:30 before the Thanksgiving break. And then Boston College here at the Robbins Center. Spies got a little payback there for BC after the game up there that they really did have a chance to win, lost in overtime.
Well, one thing about it, I know these guys are looking forward to playing some of those teams like that.
Wojcik still can't get untracked, missing that deep three. Let him take a couple more. Spiders need him to get going.
They're going to need Jake throughout the year for sure. Got to get him playing, more playing time.
Washington fouled by Tyler Burton. With 3:09 to go and a 30-point Richmond lead. The largest has been 32. Leandre Washington with 11 points. Make it 12. For the Spiders now. Thomas Verbinskis checking into the lineup. Sal Caressi going out.
I was teasing Thomas. I saw him on campus the other day, Bob, and said, hey, that left-handed jumper looks pretty sweet out there. And he said, it felt good just because he's all the injuries he said he's had. He hasn't been able to get on the floor.
Yep. If he's healthy, he could help. Really a pure-looking shooter. Gustafson traveling. You want to finish this thing as sharp as you can here. You have no starters on the court, so Coach Mooney certainly very much aware of that. But valuable minutes coming here for these guys.
If you're a player, Bob, you're always getting evaluated by the coaching staff. Always got to remember that.
And valuable rest for the starters as well. Remember, Richmond had a couple of injuries, right? Grant Golden had the sprained ankle. Blake Francis had the hyperextended knee. They had the whole week to rest. And now they're going to watch the rest of this game from the bench also. See, Francis played 27 tonight. Golden only 22. You know, the other night, Grant had that double-double in just 18 minutes.
It's unbelievable.
11 points, 12 rebounds. LeAndre Washington living at the free throw line. 10 of 11. Work against some pressure now. Wojcik does the ball handling. Gustafson.
See all their space. They have really nice spacing, the Spiders. So move the ball around. Good flow.
Burton's three a little bit short. With 2 minutes to go in the game. Spiders will get to 4-0. McNeese State to 2-5. Washington. I beg your pardon, that's Hutchinson. Miles Hutchinson. Gustafson off the dribble. A little bit strong. Knocked away by Verbinskis. Coming up with it is Gustafson. Drives it to the basket. Going to back pass it to Burton. A little bit too unselfish.
Yeah, coach didn't like that pass. He should have taken it to the hoop.
Yep. And Gustafson with the rebound. A minute to go. It doesn't look like the Spiders are going to get to 90 tonight. That'll break that string at three straight. But another solid offensive performance nonetheless with 14 three-pointers. 15.
Verbinskis.
We're having fun over here too.
Oh yeah. It's nice to see him play relaxed and really share the basketball, do the little things, Bob. And it's important for a basketball team. Get your confidence down.
That's a deep three that's off the mark. And it'll be Richmond ball.
In for the Spiders, number 31, Jordan Gately. He replaces Andre Gustafson.
And Coach Mooney making sure just about everybody is getting in the game tonight. There's Jordan Gately, the junior out of suburban Philadelphia. Sullivan Kulyu also in the game. He's in. They both got into the CSUN game Sunday.
Yep. It's a pretty cool name, right? Kulyu?
Yes, very cool.
Let's hope the Spiders football team can have the same result tomorrow, Bob. Finish the season out strong for the seniors.
Yep. Verbinskis, another three.
Sweet looking stroke.
That will put a wrap on this one. A 30-point Spider victory. 87-57.
Thanks, Bob. Coach, dominating performance tonight. What are your evaluation of how the Spiders came out tonight?
Well, we were certainly good, I'd say. The first, 4 minutes of the game, I think they had a lead, just because that's basketball, and from then on, we were really good. I thought, my only complaints, we tried to make a few passes that we shouldn't have tried to make in the second half, maybe trying to be one step ahead. But we were able to, move the ball nicely, find open guys. I thought, our guards played terrific. I thought Nick played great, Grant played great. So we're really pleased. Obviously, it's a nice win, and can get ourselves ready to go to New York.
I know you wanted to work on defense. You had a week, almost a week off to work on the defensive side of the ball. How was your thoughts on the defensive side?
That was good, you know, because after the first game, we were worried we'd have to score 90 points every game. But yeah, I thought it was good. I thought we're digging in. We're you know, when you work really hard at it, you start to trust each other more. You start to make some nice plays. You know, the only thing we were upset about in the first half, Zero had three threes. But other than that, I thought our defense was good. I thought we were aggressive going to the ball. And so I thought, you know, Grant really played that. Their big guy is a really good player. Grant played a really good defensive game on him. So those things are all really positive.
I know there's a lot of good individual play tonight, but I thought Teresi coming off the bench really did a nice job.
Yeah, Sal has been working really hard and has improved so much. You know, he has a little bit. He really gets the ball when it's in a crowd. He's able to rebound at both ends, has a good sense for the game. You know, he's incredibly skilled for someone his size, and he's really coming along. And, you know, he's becoming one of those guys like Ryan Butler and Greg Robbins who just stay with it, and they get to be really, really good players and seeing a lot of improvement.
All right, 4-0, Coach. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot, Beck.
All right. We'll bring in the player of the game right now. Blake Francis had a big night, 20 points individually. We'll talk to Blake right now. Blake, congratulations on your game. Let's talk about your thoughts about this first four games of the year, 4-0.
It's good. You know, we're off to a good start right now, and we're just looking to keep building on it and just keep building the team chemistry together and just looking forward to having a great year so far. Yep.
I'm going to nitpick it, but give me some of the things you need to work on going into New York next week.
A lot we need to work on. Just more things on the defensive side, you know, rebounding, just the little things like that. So,
you guys got a lot of experience as far as on the floor yourself. How's your role been coming in as a new player, sitting out last year? Talk about what you have done individually to fit into this game and this team.
Just to be aggressive on both ends. Just do what I do. Just make plays for myself, make plays for others on both sides of the ball. So,
what are you looking forward to New York against Wisconsin?
To get the win, for one thing, and you know, just go out there and have fun.
Congratulations, you guys had some fun tonight.